स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं।
Let's enter into the next sutra. Touching eyeballs as a feather, lightness between them opens into heart and there permeates the cosmos. This is the Dhyana Sutra. I can say, even in the Dhyana Sutra, very powerful technique. Dhyana Sutra for the person who has really grown in sensitivity, who is really sensitive, understand? Unfortunately, the society does not want sensitive people. It wants laborers. It wants dry intellectuals. If you are a dry intellectual, you will be paid everywhere. Professors. It wants dry people, but it does not want you to retain sensitivity in your life, because sensitive people are difficult to handle. They will be free, understand? When I say sensitive, I want you to understand the meaning clearly, not weak. People think sensitive means being weak and being open to everything. No. Sensitive means being strong and being aware of everything. Not being open to everything. Being open means something like anybody can invade you, anybody can bulldoze you. No, that is not sensitivity. Actually, if you are not sensitive, anybody can bulldoze you. Because you will not be sensitive, somebody is bulldozing you. Only after they enter your bedroom, you will suddenly wake up and say, oh, I think they entered my house. But they came and did their job and went away long before. A real sensitive person will be aware. Will be aware means you will know exactly what is coming, and you will know when to say yes and when to say no. Unable to say no does not mean sensitivity. That is egoistic. Understand? You may be having other way idea. No, person who is not able to say no is egoistic. It is ego. Only egoistic idiot will not be able to say no when he can't. See, having the clarity, when I can say yes, I'll say, when I can't say yes, I'll say no. This is a clarity. This is sensitivity. You see, the person who is that sensitive will always say yes to the right thing, always will say no to the wrong thing. But the problem is, people who think themselves as sensitive, they will say no to master. Now, I have seen many idiots who say no to master, they think they are sensitive, or they think they are very intelligent. No. But they will say yes to all the useless things. When I use the word sensitivity, being aware and ready to be spontaneously reacting or responding. A spontaneous person will not be closed. He will be completely sensitive and open. Here, this technique is for people who are sensitive, who are aware, who are open to respond spontaneously, who is not having a fixed, clear-cut ideas and frames, who is not working with those kind of mental frame, who is open, who is available. Let me describe the technique. Touching eyeballs as a feather, lightness between them opens into heart and there permeates the cosmos. I can say Mahadeva is powerfully putting you back to your center. During waking state, your energy, you, what you think as you, your identity will be centered on the Ajna Chakra, eyes. That is why 80% of the connection relationship between you and the world happens through eyes. Whenever I want to tell people, be still, I'll just tell them, close your eyes. The moment they close the eyes, they automatically become still. When they come and talk to me, I can't tell, close your mouth. I just tell them, close your eyes. No, really. And I have seen automatically they close their mouth. Telling close your mouth looks very disrespectful. Feels very hurting the ego. If I just say, close your eyes, they, without even their knowledge, they'll just close their mouth also. They'll close everything. Because the relationship happens only through eyes. Understand? Only through eyes. So, in the dream state, your identity exists in the throat center, Vishuddhi Chakra. That is why, unless you relax your throat, neck, you can't fall asleep. Even lying down, keep the neck straight, you will only feel uncomfortable. And trying to fall asleep, you will never be able to fall asleep. If you relax the neck, even if you are sitting, you will be sleeping. That you know, all of you. So, that there is no need for. All our schools and universities train you how to sit and sleep. Or how to keep your eyes open and not be attentive or aware of what is going on in the front. Now really, I have seen. Eyes will be wide open. Mouth also will be wide open. And they will be in samadhi. Really? No, but because of my experience in last 5 years with people, all kinds of people, I have seen almost all possible types of sleepings. All possible variety of sleepings. And the moment you relax your neck, whatever you may be doing, you will fall asleep. You may not go to the deep sleep, but you will fall into the dream state. Because this is the area, the moment it's relaxed, it just automatically pulls, attracts your identity. Your identity will come and stay in this. In the deep sleep state, it goes to Anagata Chakra. Understand? In waking state, Anya. In dream state, Vishuddhi. In deep sleep, Anagata. One important thing, when you are falling beyond this three state, Turiya, it goes to Anandaganda. It goes deeper than Anagata, Anandaganda Chakra. Means below the Anagata, above the Manipuraka. This is the way the consciousness, the identity travels. Your identity travels. Here, Mahadeva is giving a wonderful idea with intensity, with Sangalpa, putting the identity back to Anandaganda. Understand? Consciously, if you put your identity back into Anagata, automatically you will fall into Anandaganda. Even if you push up to the level of Anagata, means consciously falling into the silence, you will automatically fall into Anandaganda. That is why, understand one important thing, many people ask me, why do I fall asleep during meditation? Because you have to crash sleep and reach the meditation. It is on the way and you feel like you reached. Because always, either you know this or that. See, either you know Anya or Vishuddhi. Maximum Anagata, but Anagata you will not be aware. You never know Anandaganda, deeper than that. That is why on the way you feel, oh, the place feels very good. Why to travel too much? Now I am also feeling a little tired. Let me have a little rest, then we will start. And that is the way you end up. On the way, resting time, naturally you miss the purpose or the idea. You heard that there is a wonderful story. The young age, all the kids will learn this story in the school. There was one guy who was selling the hat. He will walk from his village to the market. On the way, he was resting under a tree with a basket of hats, and all the monkeys were, which was in the tree, they all came and caught hold of one on a hat. When he woke up, he saw there was no hat left. And he just danced and monkeys also danced. He just jumped and monkeys also jumped. He threw the hat and all the monkeys threw the hat. And he collected all the hats and went away and sold. This is the only part story you know. There is one more version. There is a second edition. Anyhow, he went and sold the hat. And he died. His son also came. And his son did the same job of selling the hats. And he also died. The third generation, grandson, that guy came. He is also in the same business of selling the caps. He makes the cap and he is going to the same market and he is resting under the same tree. As usual, the same way, all the monkeys have picked up his caps. And he wakes up, he sees all the monkeys are wearing. Now he thinks he knows the technique. He knows the technique, he just jumps. All the monkeys are jumping. He dances. All the monkeys are dancing. He throws the cap. Suddenly he sees one monkey which was there without cap. He came and just took the cap and ran away. Then these guys started shouting, "No, no, this is not fair. How come you guys are now changing the game? When I throw the cap back, you are supposed to throw all the caps. That is the way you did with my grandfather." And beautifully that leader of the monkey group says, "You did not learn from your grandfather, but we learned from our grandfather." Understand? You did not learn from your grandfather, we learned from our grandfathers. Anyhow, if you sleep on the way, this is the drama you will go through. At least now, learn. Stop sleeping on the way. When you are traveling, the Vishuddhi is like a tree. It will really feel like, why not rest? But if you rest, sometime you lose the cap, sometime you may lose even the head. So, you do not know which one you will lose. Mahadeva is giving a very powerful technique. Just through intense intention. Satya Sangalpa. Understand? There are different Sangalpas. Sangalpa which does not have your conscious support behind is a Mithya Sangalpa. Waste intention. Useless. Energy waste, time waste. Sangalpa which has your intention, your conscious support behind is Satya Sangalpa. If you have Satya Sangalpa, means ready to go into that experience of enlightenment, a courage to go through, desire, intense desire to get enlightenment, courage to go through the process, then this technique is for you. Let me describe. Mahadeva says, touching eyeballs as a feather, is asking to touch the eyeballs, means the place where your consciousness resides during waking state. After closing the eyes, just touch the eyeballs as a feather. You can even use the feather. One important thing is the feather should not bend. If it bends, naturally you are putting too much pressure. Too much pressure will not work here. You need to put right pressure. It's like a literally, it's like a playing the veena. Neither less pressure nor low, no more pressure. If it is a less, then you will not be able to create the sound. If it is too tight, if the strings are too tight, the pressure is more, again it will break. You need to give exact pressure. Actually, this balancing itself will take at least 1 month. Balancing, actually, what Mahadeva does, how much intensity you have on your identity and how much intensity you have on the world. See, your personality, your being shares half energy on your ego, half energy on your world. The I carries half energy, mind carries half energy. If the mind carries more energy, you will be completely materialistic. Working, 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 you will never like vacation. Workaholic. You will die by working. Means the mind, your wealth carries more of your attention than you yourself. I have seen people in the beginning, they will start working for wealth, and after that, even if they have wealth, they will not know how to enjoy, and they will be continuously working because it has become a habit. They will just create wealth. They will start creating wealth to enjoy. After some time, the idea to enjoy will disappear. Just wealth, wealth, wealth. What for? Just to leave everything and die. Too much of energy invested on the mind. And if the person is too much invested on mind, he will create wealth, he will not enjoy. If he is too much invested on the eye, he will be egoistic but will not have anything around him. The empty poets, or not even poets, poets will be very sensitive. Empty intellectuals will have a tall talk. They know how to talk for 20 hours, but they will not even have how to be practical to raise their next meal. The eye-centered, mind-centered. Mahadeva is real here, giving a technique to balance a person who is exactly balancing the eye-centered and mind-centered will become enlightened. Balancing between eye and mind is what Mahadeva is teaching here, because your eyes are representative of eye. That is why it is called eye. And your hands are representative of the energy towards the world. The energy which you put towards the world, your hands represent. The energy which you put on you, your eyes represent. When you balance both of them, kind of a connection starts happening between two. The energy balance between eye and mind will happen. You will fall into the center. Understand? I can say this is one of the powerful techniques to awaken the Kundalini Shakti. The potential energy which you are carrying. It's one of the powerful tantric technique. Not only I myself practiced in my life, I have seen people who practice this technique enter into the higher consciousness very quickly, because it needs a lot of attention. You are bound to be experiencing the truth. It's like if your place is near to the city, you have to be legal, just like we. Whatever we do, city will know. We have to be completely compliant with the city's needs. Same way, this technique is a foolproof technique. In this technique, everything has to be in shape, because the technique itself is so powerfully designed. When you are touching the eyeballs like a feather, understand, lightness between them opens. You should be touching, but you should not be touching. It's like your fingers should be very close, but not pressing it. If you balance and just put your hand slowly, 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 you will see it takes a lot of time, because your hands will be shaking first, and either you will touch strongly or lightly, or you may not touch. By the time you balance, at least 20 minutes per day you have to balance. You have to try with one finger, Shambhavi Mudra. The Shiva describes this as a Shambhavi Mudra. With that, just actually Shambhavi Mudra is like this, but you can try with the simple two hands, two finger supporting on the face. You can try. When you try to touch like a feather, slowly you will see a kind of a strong energy connection getting built between the finger and the eyes. What exactly has to happen, you know? You should feel the eyes, hands, finger also has become part of the eyes. As on now, when you close your eyes, you will feel your boundary is ending inside the moment you close the eyes, your boundary ends in the eyelids. But you should touch it with such a soft way, your eye should feel it has expanded. Your eyes should feel the same sensitivity which you feel inside the eyes in the fingers also. Actually, it is a very beautiful technique to develop the sensitivity in your whole body. Practically, you will feel the same sensitivity which you are having in the eyeballs, in the nails. Understand? You have to be so sharp in your sankalpa, so subtle in your visualization. As on now, the intense life which you feel inside your eyeballs and the life which you feel on your nails, just compare. Your nails are practically dead. You don't feel life in the nails. But you feel a strong sensitivity or life in the eyes. Mahadeva is saying, bring that same sensitivity to the nails. Make your finger feel connected, not only feel connected, feel the same sensitivity of the eyeballs. It's like your eyes are always outgoing. Half of the consciousness is on your eye, half is on mine. When you close the eyes and touch, make the finger sensitive, feel connected, it looks very illogical. How can this lead to enlightenment? You will start seeing the energy circles inside you instead of outgoing. Understand? If you close it, the outgoing will stop, but inside it will be getting wasted. You will see too many scenes. If you block it with the eyes and feel the hands also sensitive, like eyeballs, you will stop seeing the scenes even inside. This is the logic how the technique works. Enlightenment will happen if you stop seeing in outside and inside. If you close your eyelids, you will stop seeing outside, but you will continue to see inside. The TV which cannot be switched off is there, doing all comedy shows and all serials, whole day going on. And whether it is a daytime or night time, some serial or comedy show is going on. And sometime 2-3 show goes on. That is the dangerous part. 2-3 shows at a time in same screen. That is the worst part. That is the worst part. And I have seen some of the comedy lines. If a agriculture show related to agriculture and the show related to beautifying, if both are mixed on each other, what will happen? Please plow the land and apply the powder, add little cream, then put little pesticide and dig it deep and put the covering paste, then add lipstick, remove the mud, both will create a big mess. That is what is exactly going on inside TV continuously. You do not know whether it is beautician course or agriculture work. You do not know whether you are learning farming or beautifying yourself. And finally you end up in what beauty we are carrying. Finally we end up in this mess. Switching off that inside TV, that will happen through this technique. When you close your eyes and put the fingertip on the eyeballs and feel, put your attention between the eyeballs and the fingertips and feel connected and make the fingertips also as sensitive as eyeballs, your whole attention and energy will be balanced, will not have energy left for seeing inside TV. The comedy show will be switched off. And there will not be any movements inside your inner space. Suddenly you will see, you fall into the center. You fall into the silence. You fall into the thoughtless state. There is no scene outside or inside. The seer is awakened. Whenever the seeing stops and the scene stops, the seer is awakened. By closing the eyes, scene stops. By putting the fingertips on the eyes and feeling connected, stops the seeing process. Naturally, the seer is awakened. When the seer is awakened, you are Rishi. That is why Rishi is called seer. Mantra drashta, who sees mantra, is Rishi. Means who experiences mantra is Rishi. Understand? It's a very powerful technique. Try in the home. It takes at least half an hour, even once, to balance. I've tried. Now trying will not work. Don't bother. It takes half an hour. Try in the home. At least it will take 1 month. But I can say, 1 month is too less time to balance yourself. To balance yourself. Try in the home. You will see the seeing will disappear into seer. Let you all achieve and radiate the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you.